Now tonight we have a very special speaker. I'd wonder if you know where is Seattle? It's a quiz. Is Seattle in North America or South America or Australia or Africa? Silly question. Anyway, Professor Tony is from Seattle. And he is a master in English education. He wrote a textbook. And what I like about Professor Tony is that he's passionate about what he's doing. It's not just teaching. He thinks about what he's doing. He lives what he's doing. And I think he has learned a lot of lessons from his career or his time as a baseball player. I don't know if he's still playing, but if he's not playing, he's training at this point. He's training his son. And I think that his little boy is going to be a marvelous baseball player like his father. So without any ado, Tony, welcome and talk to us.
Baseball. I started playing baseball before I could rock. My dad was playing catch with me. So I played baseball my whole life. I like baseball and sports because I think they teach you valuable life lessons. In sports, you have nice, successful triumphs and horrible disasters, and you experience them and you grow and you learn. So I think sports reflect an attitude you should have for life. So I want to talk about two things that happened to me when I was playing baseball when I was younger. So,
can you hear me?
Yes.
Yay. So I played baseball in college, and in one of the games I was playing second base. Second base on the chart is the 2B, right up here. And one of the things important about baseball is when the ball is hit in the air, there's a certain rule about who's supposed to catch the ball. It's very structured on how good the players are, where is the ball hit, what's happening, but there's a hierarchy of who catches the ball. For example, the pitcher. The pitcher's great at throwing, but when the ball's hit to him, usually they don't really know what they're doing. You don't want pitchers touching the ball. Just throw it, and that's it. Other guys, like the center fielder at the top, they're great at catching, and you want them to catch the ball. So, one game, I'm playing second base, and the ball is hit in the air between me and the center fielder. So it's gonna land up there. So the rules in baseball are there's the outfield and the infield. Do you know which ones the outfielders are?
LFC of RFs?
Yes. Those are the outfielders. The infielders are everybody else. If the ball is hit between those guys, the outfielders are supposed to catch it, or they're supposed to tell who's supposed to catch it. It's very simple why. So if I'm an outfielder and the ball's hit, I can see the ball, and I can see the infielder, and I can see where he's going to be, and see if I can catch it, and then I can easily yell, your ball or my ball. If I'm the infielder, then I'm running out. The ball's that way, but the outfielder's that way, and I can't see him. So I can't tell if he's gonna catch it easily. So as a second baseman, my job is try to catch the ball unless he says it's his. Then I run away and he doesn't have to worry about me getting in his way. So I'm running out and the ball's going and I'm running and running and I don't hear him say anything. So now I'm supposed to dive, jump, whatever, try to catch it as any way possible. So I'm running, the ball is in the air, and I'm about to dive. My head turns, and I see the knee of the center fielder right here. He was running full speed to catch the ball. I'm going full speed out. So my face and his knee collided, both of us going as fast as we can. Very, very not fun. Of course, I drop down. My whole face hurts. I'm on the ground, I can't see. I know something is incredibly wrong with me, and I can't move, I can't do anything. I'm just on the ground. So the team, the doctor, runs out, and they're checking me. And after about 15 minutes, I can finally open my eyes, and I can look around, and the pain was more centered around it right here. So I walk off the field after a while, go to the hospital, and they check me and take care of me, and then I go to the dentist. And what had happened was his knee had hit right here on these two front teeth. The teeth had snapped back. It broke. This teeth shattered in half, and they were stuck in the top of the inside of my mouth. So I also had a severe concussion and stitches, and my lips were all bloody. Not fun. Horrible situation. So, of course, they fixed it up, and when you have a big accident like that, the doctor will give you painkillers. Painkillers are very simple. You take them like a pill, and in a way, it's like a drug. It is a drug. It makes it so you don't feel the pain, because that hurts a lot, but at the same time, your mind is just kind of gone. You're off in la-la land, and you don't know what's happening around you. So a couple days after that, we're at another game, and I've taken the painkillers, I'm staring off into space, and our second baseman is playing, and he's making big mistakes, striking out, horrible things like that, and the coach looks at me, and he says, "Tony, can you play?" And if the coach ever asks you if you can play, the answer is always yes. You never say no. Because if you say no, next time he won't ask you. Very simple. So I barely even hear he's talking to me. I'm like, "Oh yeah, coach, I'm good, put me in." And so he says, okay, go hit, you're up right now. And I'm I need a helmet. Yeah, put on my helmet. Hurry up, Tony. Bat. I need a bat. So I go up to hit. Switch to a new slide. Okay, so this box, this is the strike zone. The pitcher throws it, he tries to throw it in the strike zone. If it's in there, it's a strike. If you swing, it's a strike. Basic rules of baseball. Most hitters, what they think is, if the pitch is in here, you swing. If the pitch is not in here, don't swing. Swing at strikes, don't swing at balls. That's what most hitters think. And so I come up to the plate, and I'm up. The pitcher throws a pitch, and he throws a really good pitch. He throws it right here. This is a spot, it's a strike. But if I swing at that pitch, that's not a pitch I hit well, and I'm just gonna hit it really weak and it's gonna be out. So because I'm on these painkillers, the pitcher throws it, I'm like, that's gonna be a strike. But I don't really care, because the painkillers, wow, strike one, I don't care. Who cares? Strike one. Okay, that's nice. So then he throws another pitch, and this time it's outside, and I think that's a ball, don't swing. Wrong one. Throws the next one, and again, it's another pitch right here, a pitch I can't swing at, and I'm thinking, okay, strike two, I don't care, whatever, strike two, okay. Then he throws another pitch out here, ball two, and then he throws another pitch right here. So like I said, the pitch here, if I swing at that, I will hit it weak, but if I could ask for a pitch, I would want it right here, exactly where he throws it. And so I think, I better swing at this, because this is a really good pitch. So I swing, hit it, and I hit it so hard that when the ball was flying away, I could hear it going zoom, like that sound, taking off. And so I take off to first base, and I'm looking out, the center fielder's running back and running back, and all of a sudden, I look down, I step on first, and I'm going to second base, And then I hear everybody start cheering, and I look over and the center fielder starts slowing down, and I'm thinking, oh my God, he just made like this over-the-shoulder catch and caught the ball, the hardest ball I've ever hit in my life, and it's just an out. And so then I'm thinking, wait a second, we're the home team. If he caught the ball, why would people be cheering? That's so weird. Wait a second, did I just hit a home run? And so I'm thinking, I might have hit a home run, I don't know. And so I round second base, and I don't know what to do. I look at the umpire, and the umpire's just looking at me, and nobody's doing anything. And so I'm thinking, okay, I guess I'm just going to go to third base, and if the coach does this, that means it's like high five, you hit a home run, then I'll go home. If he doesn't, then I'll go into the dugout, because then I think he caught it. And so I get to third base, I look out, and he does this, and I'm like, oh, that's awesome, I hit a home run. So I go home. That's the only home run that I ever hit in my college career. I didn't even see it leave the park, barely even felt it, didn't even think about anything. So after the game, I was talking to some of my friends, and they were kind of making fun of me because I didn't have any teeth right there. So they're saying, wow, that really sucks, Tony. You can never bite into an apple again, or you can, you know, like never do these things, and how can you go kiss a girl without teeth? So I'm thinking, yeah, that does suck. That's really horrible. And then I start thinking, like, wow, I'm so unlucky. But then I start thinking, am I unlucky? Because what else could have happened? What if I hit his knee a little bit lower? Then these teeth could have been knocked out too. Instead of losing two teeth, I could have lost four teeth. That sucks. And then I started thinking, what if I hit him down here in my jaw? That could break my jaw. That might kill me. Yeah, that's definitely a worse situation. What if I hit him over here? Then the impact of two people going full speed, hitting like that, that probably would have broke my neck, and I would be paralyzed or dead. If he hit me up here in the nose, that would drive my nose back into my brain, and I would be dead. If he hit me in the eye, my eye would have burst, and I would be blind. So I started thinking about all these things, dead, paralyzed, blind, lose four teeth, lose two teeth. I think losing two teeth is probably the best situation. So instead of thinking about how unlucky I was, I started thinking, this might have been the luckiest event I've ever had. If you think of it, going as fast as you can, smashing your face into somebody else's knee who's also going as fast as he can, and only losing two teeth, that's a really good outcome. I got kind of lucky. And then also, because I got hit, because I broke my face, I took the medicine, the painkillers, which taught me to be a better hitter, and then I hit my only home run. And I realized, again, this is sports teaching life lessons. So I realized everything that happens in life, as horrible as it sounds, can be predicted. So when you think about it, like you take GEO class from me or Professor Johan, and we get a C+, instead of thinking, oh my God, I've got to take the class again, you could think, wow, maybe when I take the class again, I'll meet my girlfriend there. Yeah, that could happen, or my boyfriend. Or whatever happens, there's always something that could be worse. And perspective is the most important thing in life. How you look at things really is important. Don't think about the worst situation or how bad it is. You should be thinking about what else could have happened. How can I make this better? What good can happen from this? Every bad thing has a good thing, and every good thing has a bad thing. So even though I broke my face, I hit a home run, and I realized things about life. So that's my story.